house. And as you sit, put your hands together one time and give God some praise. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God is a good God. Mercy endureth forever. Truth to all generations. Know ye that the Lord is God, and it is He that have made us, and not we ourselves. So we're going to find ourselves just giving Him some thanks, giving Him some praises, and blessing His holy name. For the Lord inhabited the praises of His people. And when His praises go up, blessings will come down. Anybody need a blessing today? Anybody really need a blessing? You know, all you got to do is give God some praises. Because if you send up some praise, He's going to send down a blessing. And not only will the blessings come down, but the blesser Himself will come down. Oh, yeah, and the book said, well, the Spirit of the Lord is. There is liberty, and liberty is freedom. I feel freedom flowing in the air. Oh, yes, I can feel deliverance in the air. And the book said to them that fear the name of the Lord shall the Son of righteousness arise with healing in His wings. So whatever infirmity that you are experiencing today, whatever you are dealing with, oh, I want you to know that He's flying through with healing in His wings. You can be set free. You can be healed and delivered. All you got to do is reach up and touch the hem of His garment. And there heals enough medicine in the hem of His garment to heal the world. Oh my God, and we do understand that our healing didn't just come to the H-E-M, but it came to the H-I-M that was connected to the H. Oh my God. Even though you touched the H-E-M, but the H-E-M connected to the H-I-M, and that's where the healing came from. The healing. Oh my God. He said Israel came out of Egypt and passed through the Red Sea and went through the wilderness. He said, and Israel knew not that I had healed her. Oh my God, there's healing for the nation, for the mind, for the soul, for the spirit. Everything we need, God's got it. My God. Why don't you repeat after me? God got it. I need it. And I'm going to get it. Help me in your Holy Ghost. We don't have to go on and suffer and be defeated by the enemy. When amazing sight the Savior standing and knocking at every door. 10,000 blessings in His hand to satisfy you more. It's God's will. And His people be blessed. Oh, we love all of you. May God bless you. May His peace be with you. And in spite of what you're going through, you must yet lift your hand and say, I am what God says I am. I am more than a conqueror through Him that loved me. Oh, my God. Anybody feel like a conqueror today? Feel that you are the top, that you are the dominator, that you are in control, because God has given you control. He said in a place, and they begin to say, well, who art man? Who is man? That you so mindful of. You made him a little lower than I. Maybe they tell you something. God gave the angels power, and God gave us power. Do you remember down there in Sodom and Gomorrah when the gay people was coming to pull Lot out of there and make him submit to the sin that they were doing, and Lot tried to get them to go and they wouldn't go? Finally, the angel just said to himself, that's enough. Reached and grabbed Lot, pulled Lot in, smote him with blindness and shut the door. God has given us power to blind the devil with. Take the victory. them towards you. Now somebody else's thoughts may not be towards you the way God thoughts are. I said, but I got thoughts of peace to give you an expected end. Oh my God, and my thoughts are to bless you and prosper you. And God will go way beyond your wildest imagination. God will go beyond your expectation. If you just get a hold to him, look to him. The Bible said when they look to him, their hearts would light. Faces were not ashamed. Bless his holy name. I'm just to move on to the word of God. But we do thank God for the saints, for all the prayers of the saints. And want you to be encouraged and hanging there. And in spite of what's going on, we must always realize that God is in control of every out of control situation. It don't matter how out of control it seems, God is yet in control of it. And we do serve a tough God for these tough times. All we have to do is just hold on to him. Praise his wonderful name. Amen. Let us go to the word now. If you would turn with me to the book of Deuteronomy then. The 7th chapter, the 31st through the 35th verse. The book of Deuteronomy 2, 31 through 35. The Israelites were on a journey on their way to the promised land. Many things coming before them, but God have already shown them what he could do by bringing them out of Egypt. And I'm sure there's not a one person in here who can recall something spectacular that God have done for you. So just hold on to him. God is not through yet. Oh my God. Listen, it's not over till God says it's over. Hold on to his unchained hand. Deuteronomy 2, 31 through 35. When you have it, shout glory. Glory. Read it.
And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have begun to give Sihon and his land before thee, began to possess, that thou mayest inherit his land. Then Sihon came against us, he and all his people, to fight Jahaz. And the Lord our God delivered him before us, and we smote him and his son and all his people. And we took all his cities at that time and utterly destroyed the men and the women and the little ones of every city. We left none to remain.
Yes.
Only the cattle we took for a prey unto ourselves and the spoil of the cities which we took.
God bless you. We thank God for the reading of the scripture. May the word bless everyone that here on today, and especially those that will just buckle down and do the holy word of God. As I speak to you today from this title, God gave it and we took it. Say that with me if anybody feel that. God gave it and we took it. I watch many times as we go through life, we look at life how it is, and sometimes we complain, we feel sorry for what we don't have, but how many of us understand that God have given you everything you need? The book said God have given us all things pertaining to life and godliness. God didn't leave a leaf unturned. It is there before you, but the question arises, have you taken it yet? It's yet there. The Bible said, I have not seen, ear have not heard, nor have it entered into the heart of men. The good things God has for his people, them that love him. Anybody love the Lord today? It's there before you. All you got to do is get up and fight and take it. He told the children of Israel, I have a land that flows with milk and honey, but you must go and possess it. Book said, after the death of Moses, the word of the Lord came to Joshua, the son of Nun, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. But I want you to rise. That rise means get up. You and this people. And go over Jordan. As I was with Moses, so shall I also be with you. Just be strong and very courageous. And every inch of ground that the sole of your feet tread upon, that have I given thee. Oh yes, God have put it there before us. But it's up to us to take it. I'm reminded here, I think about in Samaria, how Elijah had prophesied and let them know what was going to take place. And there were four lepers that they put in the suburbs of the city. And while they were there, they were sitting there waiting on death. Oh, turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, what are you waiting on? Oh my God, I hope it's not death. But they sit there just waiting for death. Finally, one began to talk to him and began to say, why sit we here and die? Why would we just sit and die and let the enemy do what he wants to do to us? He said, let me tell you, we don't have to sit here and die. We can do something about it. You don't have to complain about your situation. You can do something about it. Oh, you don't have to feel sorry for yourself because of the state that you are in. You can do something about it. So one been caught on some faith and began to talk to him and said, why sit we here and die? He said, let's get up from here. Oh my God, touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, let's get up. Oh my God, and I know as we speak into the spirit that's in them. Let me tell you something, that spirit dropped. Oh, we dropped. Because the book said the body without the spirit is dead. But he began to talk to them and tell them, he said, if we sit here, we gonna die. He said, if we get into the city, then the syringe catches and kills us. He said, but we gonna only die. Yeah. He said, but there might be a chance. All right. If we get up in here and run for our life, make it to the city, that they might save us alive. He said, but one thing we do know, that if we sit here, we gonna die. Oh, I wonder how many of us realize that if you just sit there, you gonna die. So the word began to roll among them and they began to talk. And finally they were convinced to get up from there and make it for themselves. And when they got up from there, let me tell you something. The old folks said, you make one step, he'll make two. And Jesus said, draw nigh to God. God will draw nigh unto you. But when they got up and began to make it for themselves, oh, help me here, Holy Ghost. God got in their feet. But God have given us the victory. But as they passed through, in the text, if you would notice what she was reading, it said, but Sion rose up to fight against them. It's not a question as if the enemy come against us. Will he come against us? He may come against us. The enemy will come against you. Because the book said, in this world you will have tribulation. But in me you will have some peace. And Jesus said, my peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, but giveth I unto thee. Let not your heart be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. Oh my God, they could not make it to the promised land if they were going to be drawing back. They could not make it to the promised land if they sit in one spot. But he went on to say, cast therefore not away your confidence. Confidence is faith, trust, hope. He said, don't cast it away, but it have great recompense reward. He said, you have need of patience, that after you've done the will of God, you might obtain the promise. And yet a little while, And I know it looks like a long time. It looks like forever. It looks like God is not going to answer prayer. It looks like he's not coming to our rescue. But in a little while, he that come will come and not tarry. But the just shall live by faith. But if a man draw back, my soul will have no pleasure in him. For we are not of them that draw back into perdition, but we believe to the, oh, help me, Holy Ghost, to the saving of the soul. God gave it, and we took it. And if I'm allowed to ask the question today, what have you taken? Have you taken the victory? Have you taken peace for a troubled mind? Have you taken joy in your soul? Have you taken deliverance in your spirit? Have you taken power in your walk with God? What have you taken? God gave it and we took it. Now, as we look at Israel here, God had told them, I have given it into your hand. Israel got up, my God, and they went forward. Oh, let me tell you something, but the king rose up against them. But they remembered what God said. I have given even King Sihon into your hand. You go overcome him. Now, listen to this, folks. Now, I'm talking about, but you know, things are not like they used to be. We're living in a different time. But the book said that he's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I'm the Lord and I change. Now you may have changed and changed in the wrong direction, but let me tell you something. God haven't changed. God is yet healing. He's yet delivering. He's yet saving souls. He's yet rebuking the devil. Oh, he have given it to us. Everything pertaining to life and godliness. And we see them on their journey. And God began to move for them. How many of you know if you get up and get about your father's business, God gonna move for you. The only way he's not moving because you sitting there doing nothing. When Israel got up, God fought for them. When they got up and went on their journey, God began to move. Oh, they began to overtake them. They had captured King Sihon, all of his men. And the book said they took every city. It said they took 60 cities. They took 60 cities. Help me here, Holy God. And I'm going to ask it again. But what have you taken? What have you taken? And not only did they take the city, they took the people in the city. They took everything that they had in the city. Because God had given it to you. And let me tell you something. He said there was nothing left. And everything that they didn't like in the city, they destroyed. And you sing about it and talk about it, but yet you sit there and go nowhere when there's a journey before you. God held it back all night, and then the next day, God let them know it's time to take your journey. And they rose up taking their journey. And the Hebrew writer spoke about it in Hebrew 11. He said, by faith the Israelites passed through the Red Sea. It's like they were walking on dry land with the Egyptians who was a saying after them who were drowning in the Red Sea. Oh yeah, God dried the bottom of the sea. And you know what? And God do many things for us. He bring us through some, and after he bring us through it, we start thinking, well, maybe that was a coincidence. Maybe that was going to happen like that and it really wasn't God. So God had to do something else. When they got there in the middle of the Red Sea, God wanted to realize, hey, it's me that's carrying you through. See, now that I am here, beside me there is no other. I wound and I heal, I kill, I make up alive. Neither is there any that can deliver. When they got there in the Red Sea, God let the chariot break down. Messed up a wheel on the chair. Because Israel got too comfortable thinking, it was just going to do this. You know? Now God done put a big miracle there before you, and now you saying it was just going to happen. It was not going to just happen that way. God made it happen. Yeah, sometimes we start to take the credit for it ourselves. Pin flowers on ourselves. But God said, no, baby, there ain't going to be no flowers pinned in here. Because I'm the one that's doing this. And when the chariot broke down, they start screaming and hollering again. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. But you know what God did? God took care of them. And they were going through the Red Sea, and they were pursuing, trying to get them. Then God broke them down and stopped them that they could not overtake them. Let me tell you something, God's so awesome, man. And as Google that said, the only, Jude said, the only wise God. Yeah. Yeah. I was saved. Be dominion, glory, and majesty, both now and forever. That wise God. You know what he did? He let the last one of the Israelites come out of the water. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. God's not going to mess nothing up. We got to learn to trust him. Yeah. And when that last thing, let me tell you something. God can see everyone that was out there. God knows everything. He said even the hairs on your head are all numbered. But say he tells the number of the stars. Call them by their name. Woo. And when they got through, God told Moses that it's time to use the rod again. I wonder how many of y'all have used it for the first time. But he turned and used the rod again. He waved the rod over the sea. And when he waved it over the sea, the waters began to come together. But the Israelites were on the other side. Oh, the waters come together and drowned it deep. And fulfilled the saying of Moses. When Moses said, Egyptian that you are looking at now, you're not going to see them no more. Woo, for God does to take care of it. But how many of y'all know God will take care of if we just open up our hearts and give God a chance? I come to tell you today, when trials and tribulations are standing before you, that's an opportunity knocking at your door. God will make a way. God will deliver you. God will set you free. God told him, it's time for you to make your journey. And it's time to get up from there. I want to see to do nothing. Make up in your mind. I'm going to do God's will. I'm going if I have to go alone. I am going if I have to go all by myself. From God. And God will deliver you. God will see you through. Yes, he will. As I heard the words of the Apostle Paul, and Paul said, not as though I already obtained, either was I already perfect, but I followed on, if that I might apprehend of that which I for the price. Open up your